in my presentation, I will be sharing about visual milestones and visual assessment in children. Pediatric ophthalmology is quite a fascinating branch, but sometimes frustrating as it is difficult to examine children. So whenever a pediatric case is referred or it steps into a general ophthalmology practice, it seems difficult to handle them. In this presentation, I am going to share with you the normal visual milestones in a child, which will help in pediatric vision screening, which will help to detect many vision-threatening conditions, early intervention, and better visual recovery and long-term prognosis in these children. So I will be sharing tips on estimating vision in children in general practice. Babies and children learn to see over a period of time, like they learn to walk and talk. They're usually not born with all the visual abilities they need in life. The ability to focus their eyes, move them, and use them together in coordination must be learned. Also, the visual information is sent to the brain and it's processed, and this process involves the eye, the central nervous system, and the behavioral development. Visual acuity is to assess the anatomical and functional status of the eye. When the visual system is immature, it is better to detect diseases at an early stage and treat them to prevent permanent visual loss. Neonatal vision. So visual system is relatively immature at birth, and most of the development occurs during the first year of life, which is a very dynamic period in visual development. So any pathology or insult which impairs the visual development during this period can lead to a long-standing impact. At birth, the babies only see blurry images. They only appreciate black and white images and the contrast. So they are able to see mother's face at the edges, and they are able to see the eyes. And usually the distance where they can appreciate an object would be around 8 to 10 inches away. The eyes are sometimes uncoordinated and may look cross-eyed. The infant will blink in response to bright light or touching the eye. During the first month of life, the eye starts working together and the vision rapidly improves. The eye-hand coordination improves, and the child starts looking at faces and pictures with contrasting black and white images, can follow objects up to 90 degrees, watches the parents closely, and tearing production starts. During the second and third month, the baby starts recognizing the mother's face. It's able to see objects as one image. And fixation develops. If the infant's eyes are not well coordinated and appears to be crossed, then evaluation is needed. You should worry when the baby is not fixing or following light. At 4 to 5 months, the baby becomes much more aware of the environment. They can follow a moving toy or a rolling ball, and the hand-eye coordination is improving. In this period, the control of eye movements and eye-body coordination continues to improve. Another hallmark feature is the depth perception begins during this period. The baby can pick up a toy that is dropped, develops color vision, it can play peekaboo, and begins to watch objects that are moving fast. At 12 to 48 months, they almost reach an adult stage. They're able to place shapes in proper holes, they recognize familiar objects and pictures in the book, and they're able to point out objects and also respond to gestures and actions. They're able to scribble with crayon pencil, and the vision usually reaches 20/20 during this period, and they have a normal color vision. By the sixth year, the child is able to recognize and recite the alphabets, they're able to read the Snellen's chart, and has complete depth perception, and has the capability to name coins, money, and to use scissors. Coming to the estimation, usually children are divided into pre-verbal and verbal children. The earliest visual acuity test would be Brink reflex. Like when you show a flashlight, the child starts blinking its eyes. So that is a blink reflex. The next test would be fixing and following light. So you can see here this child, this can be done at various distance. The next will be the fixation pattern. If you see here the child on the left, you can see the corneal reflex, which is seen very well in the center. Whereas the child on the left, you can see that the left eye is a little deviated, appears esotropic. So just by throwing a light and making sure that the eyes are orthophoric with the fixation center, you can judge the visual acuity in a child. The CSM method, the central steady maintain, is a simple method to check the visual status, usually done with one eye fixing an accommodative target held at 40 cm. The C refers to the location of the corneal right reflex. Normally it is in the center of the cornea and it's symmetrical. And S refers to steadiness of fixation. And M is referring to the maintenance of the fixation. So if the child is not able to maintain, that indicates a decreased visual acuity. This is just a picture to show how the examination should be done. Always uniocularly it should be done. And this is a child here where you can see that when the left eye is patched, when you are offering her a chocolate, she is able to pick up. The same thing when the right eye is patched, is resisting occlusion. She is not able to pick up the chocolate and she is crying and she is trying to remove the patch. The boy candy test is a very simple test which can be done in the office to vision assessment by giving the small different size candies. It's also called as cake decoration, and the vision approximately corresponds to 624. The next test is the Lea gratings. Is a preferential looking test, is the principle, and here the gratings of various frequencies are shown to the child simultaneously with the plain placard side by side, and this can be done in children usually between 3 months to 1 year of age. The Taylor Equity calls a similar preferential looking test where you have black stripes of varying thickness, and this is how the test is done. The examiner sits behind, there's a small hole, and observes the patient's face and the movement of the eye. The next test is the Cardiff Acuity Card or the Vanishing Optotypes. This is a test which gets done between 1 to 3 years of age, where you look at the optotypes which are diminishing in contrast. The Lea Symbol Test is for older children, where the child is asked to match the symbol shown at distance with the symbols given in the card child's hand. This is usually meant for preschool and kindergarten age, and they have different shapes which will attract the child. The Sheridan Gardner Test is another flip card test which can be done in little older children and also in toddlers. So this has a matching card. The person has the letters in a distance and child is able to match, and the visual acuity can be got equivalent to a Snellen's chart. To conclude, this is just about the visual milestones in children, and parents play an important role in helping the development of the child's vision by always looking for warning signs and vision problems. A preschool evaluation is mandatory to prevent vision threatening complications, and I hope the tips which we shared will help the general practitioners to do some justice to the children who present to their clinic. Thank you.